I think the weirdest thing that has started to happen over the past week since the essentially the fall of Afghanistan is the fact that we have Republicans that are openly coming out and praising the Taliban. We have seen it from Marjorie Taylor Greene. We have seen Donald Trump Jr. or not Marjorie Taylor Greene, excuse me, Lauren Boebert. We have seen it from Donald Trump Jr., where he said, hey, they're not wrong, when they attacked Facebook for alleged censorship. But one of the more disgusting folks is, of course, Donald Trump himself. Donald Trump went on Sean Hannity's program earlier this week and gave the utmost of praise to the Taliban. But what's interesting, what was pointed out, is the fact that this wasn't the first time he's done that. Back in, I think it was April of 2020, Donald Trump had this to say about the Taliban. A year and a half ago, he says, this is a very brilliant enemy. You know, it's a brilliant enemy. They develop drugs like the antibiotics. You see it. Antibiotics used to solve every problem. Now one of the biggest problems the world has is the germ has gotten so brilliant that the antibiotic can't keep up with it. And they're constantly trying to come up with a new. People go to a hospital and they catch. They go for a heart operation. That's no problem. But they end up dying from problems. Okay, well, all right, that may not be the most eloquent statement ever because he went down several different paths. But talking about the Taliban, they're brilliant! Brilliant! And then this week, he follows it up with this a year and a half later. The Taliban, good fighters. I will tell you, good fighters. You have to give them credit for that. They've been fighting for 1,000 years. What they do is they fight. The Taliban has circled the airport, and who knows if they're going to treat us right. All of a sudden, they'll say, well, frankly, if they were smart, they'd really, and they are smart, they are smart, they should let the Americans out. Okay, the Taliban was actually formed in the 1990s. That's not exactly 1,000 years ago. You know, you're off by like 970 some odd years, but sure. They're smart. They're brilliant. They're good fighters. I'm old enough to remember, because we got called this all the time back in our early days here at Ring of Fire, when Republicans would tell anybody who didn't support the war in Iraq that you were a terrorist sympathizer. But today, we have Republicans openly coming out praising the terrorists, and we're just supposed to suddenly be okay with this after y'all threw that crap at us for a decade, because we didn't want Americans dying over there in a needless, endless, unwinnable war. And now here you are, just because a Democrat got troops out of Afghanistan, trying to praise the Taliban because you hate Joe Biden so much. Can we be honest, folks? That's what this is. That's what all of this praise for the Taliban is. They hate Joe Biden so damn much, they would rather side with the damn terrorists. And that's what Republicans are doing. But nobody is doing it in a more ass-kissing way than Donald Trump.
Thanks for watching. And don't forget to like, comment, share, and most importantly, subscribe to our channel for fresh content 7 days a week.